Okay, so I'm now loaded into the official asset server that we use for flight training. This is a persistent server hosted by Tech Sergeant Hardman, where we do most of our training at for flight. All the flight aviation elements. So we have the A-10s over there, Thunder. We have our Apaches, call sign Warlord. We have our Little Birds, call sign Lancer. And then we have our CH-46s, which are Phoenix Heavy. And then our Blackhawks, which are Phoenix. So this is. This is going to be gonna go over day one stuff again, just make sure I have everything refined, and then maybe just do some flying around. I'm the only one in the channel right now, so right. Multiple radios that we have to carry. So we have to set them all up. And I'm trying to remember, I don't have my sheet with all my radio freaks, so I have to. There's a lot to remember. I got the main frequencies down, it's just those second and third radios that I kind of forget what I'm supposed to be listening to. Is our reinsert net. If there's trooper that goes down for technical difficulties or whatever, that's what he'll call us on. So those are all set. And I'm gonna tab out of here for a second. Okay, so first we do our walk around the bird, making sure that there's no obstructions or anything like that, which there shouldn't ever be. set up our long range. Seven nine is our search and rescue net. All right, so that's all set up. So let's get into the map. So to mark our, I think most of the time these will be marked, but these are hold short markings. And then lastly is our taxiways. Drop one here, mark this airfield as Gravia Air Base. Okay, so that's all set up. So now we're going to set up my flight plan. This is, I just know this from doing it so many times. That's 2-1, and this is 0-3, and then we have, we didn't really specify whether this was a hold short or whether it was a taxiway, so I've been labeling it as a hold short. Also, helicopter parking. AAC airfields are already labeled. So my flight path is going to be we're going to come out here and about there. We're going to take a little turn over the water, and then we're going to head straight into here, and then I'll land there. What I've been doing then from there is I've been flying either to Molos Airfield or Elmira here. I think today we're going to do Mullis again. And this was, '04. And this was, '22. And then we have, one. I did not mark this the last time I practiced it because I didn't see it. And Sierra 2. And then Mike 1. And then over here is the hangar. That's where my helicopter parking will be. So my plan is take off down the flight line, down the runway to here. And then from here, I am going to do a direct takeoff. Oops. I'm going to do a direct takeoff to the east. And we're going to turn northeast up here. Now, what I want to do is avoid flying over as many towns as I can. So I may not stick directly to this flight path, but basically something along this line to here. And then from there, we'll come in here, taxi, land, and then I'll fly out here, make a hard turn out over the ocean. And I will come down here and land at helicopter parking, direct landing. So that's my plan for today. Once I do that, then we'll see how it goes. Gravity Air Base, this is Phoenix 24 on Mike 1 helicopter parking, 1x UH-60, Blackhawks spooling up. And that's actually Mike 3 helicopter parking. Gravity Air Base, this is Phoenix 24, lifting from Mike 3 helicopter parking, taxiing down to Sierra 7, for runway 22 right. I'm using mouse and keyboard. Again, my plan is to, once I get through flight school, could switch over to a joystick and rudder configuration, but right now I don't want to screw myself up anymore by trying to learn something new. Gravity Air Base, Phoenix 24, holding short at Sierra 7 for runway 22 right, departure to the southwest. Gravity Bravo Air Base Phoenix 2-4, taking active runway 22 right. Gravier Base 2, Phoenix 2-4 on active runway 22 right, going full power. And what I've been doing is I've been trying to maintain an altitude of 100 ASL above sea level for most of my flight. Trying to hold that steady, and I'm going to try and hold about a 150 speed there. Gravity Air Base Phoenix 2-4, signing off 7-5, good day. AC Airfield, this is Phoenix 2-4. Signing on 7-5, approaching from the northeast. Drop down to about 50 meters. Maintain our speed. Correction, AAC Airfield. This is Phoenix 2-4 on final for runway 21. AC Airfield, this is Phoenix 2-4 taking active runway 2 right. AC Airfield, Phoenix 2-4 back taxiing on runway 03 to Sierra 1 helicopter parking. Rudder, as you see, it's herky jerky. I don't get a nice smooth rudder movement out of it, which I definitely would like. AC Airfield, this is Phoenix 2-4 on the deck, Sierra 1 helicopter parking. Alright, so from there we're gonna fly here to Mullis Airfield. AC Airfield, this is Phoenix 2-4, lifting off from Sierra 1 helicopter parking, direct departure to the east. do that. Oh, yeah, that was bad. Let's get kind of discombobulated there. Again, we're going to climb to 100 ASL, maintain 150. Mainly I'm doing this just so that I can learn to control my speed and altitude. Hopefully that'll help me with formation flying. Hey, see airfield, this is Phoenix 2-4 signing off on 7-5. Good day. Dagger, this is Phoenix 2-4 signing on 7-0. There. So Dagger is our JTAC call sign. Joint Tactical Air Controller, I believe. That's our Air Force guys that basically are our air traffic control. They're the ones who direct all of our support missions, our CAS missions, give us basically all of our tasking and everything like that. So. They're usually on 7-0, and they're the ones that would be calling us for resupplies or any CAS missions, calling out targets, things like that. Seven-1 is our air-to-air frequency, and 7-1.1 is our rotary-to-rotary frequency, so I'm believing that 7-1 would be like if I needed to call the A-10, and then 7-1 would be communications in between the birds. Again, we already covered 7-9 as our search and rescue frequency. If we go down, or if a pilot's down, and then 5-1 is our reinsert net in case one of our troopers has a technical issue or is KIA or something like that and needs to be airlifted from base back to the AO. So it's not the high adrenaline, low flying crap of like a Koth server, but it is very precise and technical. That is our urban warfare center. That's a really awesome center where we can practice urban warfare training, mount operations, mounted, dismounted, that kind of thing. I haven't had a chance to do that yet because our training was canceled. But hopefully someday soon here I'll be able to do that. I need to do that. I need to do air assault school, which I'm not really sure when our next one is going to be. Probably, I think we just did one about 2 weeks ago, so probably sometime in April, I think. I gotta figure out a way, if there's a way to move that watch so that I can see my TADS display, because that watch kind of blocks my TADS. I don't know if there's a way to move it or not. I tried going into interface or to layout and didn't see anything for it. Dagger, this is Phoenix 24 signing off 70. Good day. Mullis Airfield, this is Phoenix 24 signing on 75. We'll be approaching from the south, southwest. And again, switching between frequencies there. I let my speed dip. Maybe a key binding for that. And we'll go ahead and drop down a little bit more. Mullis Airfield, this is Phoenix 24 on final approach to runway 04. Mullis Airfield, Phoenix 24, taking active runway 242, Sierra 2. Mullis Airfield, Phoenix 24, off active runway 2. Correction, clear active runway 2. Passing Sierra 2. And a little tongue tied there. Melissa Airfield Phoenix 2-4 on the deck. Mike 1, helicopter parking. Alright, and from there we will lift off and actually head back to our base. So we are going to go 04 departing from the northeast. Mullis Airfield, Phoenix 2-4, lifting off from Mike 1, helicopter parking, taxiing to Sierra 1 for runway 04. Mullis Airfield, Phoenix 2-4, holding short at Sierra 1404, runway for departure to the northeast. Mullis Airfield taking active runway 04. Mullis Airfield on active runway 04. Full power departure to the northeast. Mullis Airfield, this is Phoenix 2-4, signing off 7-5, good day. Dagger, Phoenix 2-4, signing on 7-0. Speed to about 200 over the water here. Flight path. single player editor I've been practicing. Some day two stuff. Well, day two's formation flight, route planning. Kind of been sort of doing route planning in here. But it's formation flight. I can't really do that on my own. And then it is also auto rotation. So I've been practicing that on my own editor that I have set up almost identical to this. I don't want to do auto rotation by myself in here because this is a perpetual server. So if I wreck a bird, the way I understand it, that stays until the server's reset, and I don't know anything about that kind of thing. So I'm not going to be doing auto rotation today. Dagger, this is Phoenix 24, signing off 70. Have a good day. Gravity Air Base, this is Phoenix 24, signing on frequency 75, approaching from the northeast. Military compound there. To our left is the training center where they do in the official servers. This is pretty much set up identical to the official servers, but the official servers, that's where they'll do their OSUD and recruit training and all that. Gravity Airfield, this is Phoenix 24 on final for direct helicopter parking, Mike 1. Correction, direct helicopter parking, Mike 3. Gravity Airfield, this is Phoenix 24. On the deck at Mike 3, helicopter parking spooling down. Yeah, I still stutter a little bit on my communications. Gravity Airbase, this is Phoenix 24, signing off 75. Good day. Alright, so like I always do after I finish a flight is I will get out and see how I did on my landing. A little to the left, but not terrible. I didn't take out any fences. Bird's not damaged, so I call that a successful flight. So, thank you for watching, and have a great day.